and can't stand other dogs. Those are two dogs that came out on my property with dog-dog issues. Now, what are they thinking now? I don't know. Nor do I care. As long as they do that and don't fight, that's all I care. I don't care if they go out afterwards and hang out. It doesn't matter to me. When you're in place, you can't fight with a dog that's in another area or right next to you. I'll often have 10 dogs in my van. Do they like each other? I don't know. Do I ever have a fight? Never. Because if I hear any growling, any elevation of energy, enough. So whoever wasn't doing anything wrong, well, they got that too. And I really don't care because that's how we stop fights. That's off-leash work. I'm a big fan of off-leash. But, what's the name of the dog? Where is that race? Bowie. Bowie doesn't like other dogs. Sitting there making up. Oh, here we go. That's another dog that doesn't like other dogs. And that's a really nice...
Last episode?
No, what's the dog?
Caton de Tullier.
What's that?
The Caton de Tullier.
Yeah.
And pumpkin.
Pumpkin. So, a 5-dog down thing. This was actually last week. I mean, this is what I do. A place command in my office. Dogs that are around children.
Hey, he's here. Good boy. All the way. Good, good.
The dog way in the head. He was out his last night.
All the way.
And now he's all off the street on the beach, out in the park.
All the way. All the way. Good.
Thank you. Don't go to God Park now. This is somebody that, okay, this is our second session. Look at this. Can we all see that? She could not walk one dog an hour prior to this, let alone three. The two small ones would fight. I mean, to me, that's training. To me, that's training. No pulling, no barking, no dragging. Roka and Ronin. Ronin's up for adoption. He's a Kendall from Turkey. And you'll see some photos up there. When he was born, at about 4 months old, a Turkish boy rescued her, boy, and he cut off his ears. It's popular in Turkey to, the Turkish Kengals, they crop their ears because they're actually trained to protect livestock, and they want them against the wolves, so they want to be able to crop their ears. But he just took a pair of scissors and cropped them. Like, no medication, nothing. There's a woman in Germany called the Kengal Lady of Germany. She rescued him, got him proper medical attention. Unfortunately, they had to remove all of his outer ear. And then he went to a family in Massachusetts, and now he's with me until I find him home. I may or may not keep him. But he was terrible off-leash. He runs off-leash with Roka. Now, to me, that's training. That's training to me. Who doesn't want their dog to run off-leash, like, on some guy's private property that doesn't know we're there? That's training. Living harmoniously with your dog, unleashing your dog's true spirit. A lot of times people will say, this one's sleeping now, but Uma, people will say, oh, how sad. Your dog looks so sad. She looks so sad. And no, she's balanced. She's relaxed. She's okay. And I give this comparison a lot to Playboy and Penthouse, where we look at these magazines and we assume every woman looks like that, and then we open up Dog World and we assume every dog is like, smiling. No, they're not. This is what well-behaved dogs look like. So there's a difference between training and behavior. And if you listen to my show, you'll know I met with Cesar Millan 3 or 4 weeks ago out of California. And one of the things that he shared with me was that a lot of his dogs at his property don't actually know obedience stuff. They don't know sit. They don't know down. But they're balanced. They're balanced. There's a big difference between obedience and behavior. Like a lot of competition agility dogs, competition show dogs, a lot of them are really badly behaved. And they come to me, and I have to sign this long disclaimer, because no, they don't want the organization to know they had to come to me and get their dog trained. Making sure that your dog is not one of 5 million. To me, that's important. That's why I do this. I don't want your dogs to be 1 in 5 million. That's what I do. So, how do we do this? We have to redefine our relationship with our dog. I love sushi. I love the handbag. I love those shoes. I love my dog. Stop loving your dogs. Start caring about your dogs. We understand? Start caring about your dogs. So redefining our relationship. Okay. Housebreaking. I'll go a little bit on housebreaking. We're gonna have question and answer at the end too. Housebreaking your dog, my philosophy is this. The dog should be in the crate when you're not looking at it. And the dog should be in the crate overnight. And your dog should be in the crate when you're not home. We're foolish if we allow our dogs to have real estate if they have yet to earn the real estate. How do you earn real estate? No destruction, no soiling. Now you earn real estate. Simple as that. Jeff, my dog is peeing all over the house, on my kid's bed. Why does your dog have access to that? I don't like gates. I like crate. Until you agree to crate train your dog, don't waste your money hiring me because I don't know what to tell you. So we crate train our dog before we house break our dog. I don't even use newspaper because I'm not going to train my dog to pee inside. Dogs don't know inside of the house from outside of the house. All they know is sleeping quarters from non-sleeping quarters. So the whole house is a free reign. So we got to, genetically, they don't do the bed. Everything else, they don't know. So we have to get them outside. One of the things I do anytime you have a puppy at home or a new dog, it should be on a leash in the house during the waking hours when you're around. Every dog should have a leash on, drag it around. Now, I don't want to live that way for the rest of my life, and I'm sure the dog doesn't, but I also don't want to pick up a dog. So if I want my dog to go to point A to point B, I'm going to pick up the leash and I'm going to walk. If I want my dog to go to the bathroom in the same spot outside, I'm going to pick up the leash, walk to that, stand there like this, wait till it goes. So housebreaking is crate training first. Crate training dog is this. I take away food and water 3 to 4 hours before bedtime. 2 to 3 times prior to bedtime, I take the dog out to the exact same spot. I stand there, tell it to go potty. Don't go, I did good. You don't do that. Don't raise up your voice like that. Stop raising up our voices like that. You could potty. Don't feed him a treat to go to the bathroom. The dog's in extreme cases. I'm sitting in the client's house. I'm watching the dog pee on the floor, and then walks over to the kitchen and sits down in front of the cookie jar. You train the dog to pee, but not outside. You shouldn't get a reward for peeing. It gets an empty bladder for peeing. So it goes outside. You say, go potty. I'm a big fan of go potty. Give it a command. I let my dogs to pee on command. Because when I go to New York, when I'm there every month, I gotta let my dogs out. I don't use those fenced in areas because they're disgusting. No one's ever cleaned them before. So my dogs go somewhere else. Go potty, get in, then I go in and I go to the bathroom. So, oh, that's one. She's not alone. Rating and thresholds. We want to use see what this rule got. Okay, Dan here. Let's do it going down the steps. So bring her up the steps and then down the steps. And then up the steps. That's fine. That's mean. Here's a good example. What are we going to do? We're going to stop, we're going to drag. We're going to drag, which is mean and abusive. Right? Okay, come back up. Keep going. Okay, now we're going to go down. This is how we wait for the pressure. We go to the threshold like this. If my dog, say this was outside, she's doing, obviously she's doing something. But say this was the door to outside. I don't say wait, and I don't say stay. Every threshold is unspoken. Inside the house to outside of the house. Outside of the house to inside of the house. In my car, out of my car. The slider to the backyard, a threshold is a threshold. You do not cross it without permission. I'm not going to say wait, I'm not going to say stay. It's too many words. It's implied. Anything that Jeff does is implied. Mouth closed. So normally, if Andrew went to disturb this well-mastered dog, Scott would be like, oh, this is way, let's get on the steps. So what you do is you just back, gentle back. And the dog's like, oh, okay, I guess we're not supposed to cross the threshold. And then you walk towards the threshold again. If the dog doesn't stop you, do that again. I assure you that two or three times when the dog gets to the threshold, they stop and they look up at you. What do you want me to do, Jeff? Thank you for asking. We don't say thanks for asking. That's sort of the mental thing we do with our dogs. It's like, wow, look at that. I didn't have to tell you what to do, but I got a leash on you in a training camp and you did it. And then we say, okay. Okay means now you can eat your bowl, now you can leave the house. Every door. Why? I know we have 100% fenced in yard, but maybe your aunt or uncle at the vacation home doesn't. I know you've got 3 acres of land, but when you go to a hotel and the street's 10 feet away, it's different. Out of a car, when you lift up your hatchback, maybe you're in your driveway now and it doesn't matter, but how about when you're at the supermarket? Or how about when you're on a public street? You do not cross a death threshold without permission, ever. So, if you can't, if you've got a sliding door, what do? Close the door. Cut the dog in half, but close it. But their face might get a little bit, oh, oh well, stop brushing off doors. That's not mean or abusive. What's mean or abusive is a dog getting hit by a car. And if they don't get killed, it costs us $5,000 to put it back together again. And all we had to do was give them a little bit of a pop. It'll last the rest of their life. All right? Let's go. Thanks. Great impressions. Oh, in and out, we do the same thing for the crate. Can someone bring the crate up on stage, please? Every dog should learn how to kettle lock. Every dog. Maybe you don't have crates on your property, but if it stays with me, or if it stays with a dog day here, or if it stays in a regular place, it might. Okay. So, how many times does somebody say, I can't get my dog to go in the crate, Jack? I throw treats in there, clonks in there, all this stuff, the dog doesn't go. Okay, this is how we do it. Walk.